Do you ever do things wrong, make mistakes while you're in the midst of using a system? I just did a recording where I thought I was doing a recording and actually failed to select one of the options I need to select to get to the work. However, if you can understand why mistakes happen, then you're in a far better position to put them right. So what we're going to do is use the execution evaluation cycle, the Norman model, in order to distinguish two classes of human errors, slips and mistakes. So first of all, slips. So a slip happens when actually you start off doing everything right. You understand what you're doing, your system goals, you understand the way the system works and you understand what you want to do. You formulate the right action plan, you decide the right thing to do. And with my video here, I decided I wanted to record my screen, which was also recording from one of my microphones. And I even had the little dialogue box for it up. And then something goes wrong, for some reason you don't do it. Now in that case, I just, for some reason, obviously missed clicking that button. Whether I forgot at the last moment or whether I thought I'd clicked, I didn't, I'm not sure. You might, for instance, in a mail system, you can imagine the user thinking, I want to save my mail for later, and they go to click the save button and they accidentally hit the delete button instead. I'm sure that's happened to you more than once when you've been using a system. Certainly it happens a lot with one of the mail systems I use. So that's a slip. I mean, and because it's at that very low level of the last action, it's quite easy not to notice that you've done it at all. And I'll just emphasize, this is an error, should we say, in the execution part of the execution evaluation cycle. You've got the right goal, but you just haven't, for some reason, something's gone wrong in the execution. A mistake happens far sooner. A mistake is when you maybe do all the things you intend to do, it's just what you intended to do was the wrong thing. So again, in a mail system, you might think, I want to save this mail message. So you see a button, it's called archive, and you think, oh yes, that's like going to a filing cabinet and putting the mail message into the right folder. So when I click archive, I'm going to be given a list of folders. You click archive and the mail message disappears. Because what archive means is I sort of save it somewhere in the background, but it's not the same in a lot of email systems as actually then putting it into a folder. So your understanding of the system was the problem. What you chose to do was what you intended to do. You pressed the archive button. It's just what you intended to do wasn't right for that system. Now, maybe after a while you learn how the system works, that doesn't happen anymore. But you know, it's sort of thing that often happens when you start using a new system and you're not so familiar with the kind of wordings. Now notice this is an error in the goal stage. Your goal was wrong. I said, the example I just gave there was because the goal was wrong because of your understanding system. Sometimes though, your goal can be wrong because your evaluation of previous steps. So for instance, when you hit that archive button, maybe you do understand archive. You've been using your mail system a lot. You know exactly what it does. You hit archive, and then for some reason you realize that the mail message you meant to archive is still there. And of course the reason for that is you thought that was a selected mail message, but perhaps a different one was selected. So your understanding of the system state based on previous evaluation of actions you did on the system was wrong. So you can both have these mistakes formed by a poor knowledge of how the system works, or you can have mistakes that are because you've got a poor knowledge of the underlying state of the system at this moment in time. Having understood this, we're now in a position to actually think, what are the best ways to fix these? And depending on which kind of errors are happening, then there are different strategies to fix them. So if this is a slip, if the person has got the right understanding of the system, and it's just that last bit of action that's going wrong, then we want to look at low-level interface things to try and prevent that bottom level interaction. We might space our buttons out further. We might make them larger so the person's less likely to click select the wrong one. What you might do is give a very low level instant feedback, something like a little beep, but one that may perhaps vary in its tone depending on what you selected, so that the user gets this instant feel about which thing happened. You know, one of those spontaneous things just appears for a moment and then disappears, or a lightning. There's various ways you can do this. But this is about just saying to the person, that's what you just did, hope that's right. And crucially, that means that if you do something wrong, you fix it. Because often the problems with slips, it's not so bad that you do them, but if you don't fix them straight away, that's often when serious problems start to occur. Of course, that doesn't help if it's a mistake. If your goal was wrong and you get the beep that says that you just pressed the right button, well, it was the right button, it was the button you meant to press. It just didn't do the thing that you really wanted to do. It does the thing you think it does, but that isn't the right thing, because your understanding of the system is wrong. Now, you notice I split these mistakes into two classes. So in fact, we've got three kinds of ways of fixing things. So one of those kinds of mistakes was when you don't understand the way the system works. So like the meaning of that archive button. Then as a designer, you can ask questions like, have I actually designed the right system here? If all the users are doing that, maybe the wording you're using is the wrong wording for that kind of user, or the model that you have for the kinds of users you're dealing with is the wrong model. You know, and maybe some users have this problem, some don't, so it's not something that you can just change the system for. Maybe what this says is you need better ways of helping to train the user. Now, that could be the first time you hit the archive button, it pops a little box up that says this is about to happen. You know, if you meant to do this instead, this is what you should do, perhaps even with an OK cancel. And one of those things that says don't show this again. Or you might show that for a while and then have it disappear. Or maybe you'll do something more reactive. You'll know you keep track in the system, and if the person is constantly doing archive and then undo and then file, maybe then next time they log in, you pop up one of those little tip boxes that says, did you know that archive was about doing this and this is how you do the other? So again, if you understand that it's a problem of understanding the system, then you can offer ways to do it. If it's the person didn't understand the state of the system, like the mail message they think is the selected one that it isn't, then you can ask, how can I improve that semantic level of feedback, the semantic presentation, so that the person understands the state of the system so they can make appropriate goals. Now, it could be that to make it a nice looking interface, your where you highlighted the selected mail message was very, very subtle. And maybe it's too subtle, it needs to be a bit more in your face. It may be that at the point at which they selected it, it wasn't very clear what was going on. So, but again, if you understand that that's what's going wrong, that they think one thing was selected and actually wasn't, then you can start to think about ways of making that more clear to them. But as a general rule, the more you understand about the kinds of errors that people make and the kinds of problems they're having, the better position you are in to do something positive that really helps them.